She's good.
Yeah.
Yeah, sweet Anne is, heart is solid, arm is getting solid. Is she?
Good.
So,
has the puppy helped?
She had trouble picking it up.
Yeah.
Even though it was little, but the puppy is, that was the source of joy.
Good.
The entire. I was like, I just was like, I want to be outside with you, puppy. Like,
because she's adorable.
It's just nothing but pureness and goodness.
And joy, just unadulterated love.
Yeah.
Like,
you can, nice. I can tell what you tell by experience.
I love them so much.
You only have one, right?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I just
in general.
Mm-hmm.
I love them.
It's, we certainly need them more than they need us.
Oh, my gosh, yes.
That's for sure. So tell me in general, like, what's going on? What have you been doing? What has been done to you? What works? What seems to stick? Any spiel? It's been a while, so
it's been a minute.
Yeah.
So today, actually, in Newburgh, I had finally an appointment with a pain specialist.
Okay.
For the first time ever in my life, and she was just like, "So you're not on any anti-inflammatories? You're not? What have you been treated for this?" And I was like, "Nothing." Nothing, dear.
So she, it's a girl.
Yeah.
So she was basically acknowledging that there's something going on.
Yeah, that's weird that I would be in chronic pain all the time. And because it's not cystic, what is it? Not fibromyalgia, the other one.
Cystic fibrosis?
That one. Because it's not that, it defaults apparently to unspecified pain disease. Those are the two. That's
wow.
It.
That's like a little bucket and then
that's
like,
it.
Pool.
That's according to my PCP, that's it. so I got a bunch of x-rays and stuff. So that's fun.
So just testing.
Yeah, a bunch of x-rays, a bunch of lab work just to see like what's going on.
Mm-hmm.
I've been doing some, we got a small stationary elliptical.
Okay.
That I do during work, so I don't have to think about it because it sucks.
Are you like sitting and is it like under?
No, I stand.
Oh, okay.
Just stand.
Okay.
It's got thingies, but I'm working, so.
So you're like,
yeah,
tickling it. Cool.
Yeah, then, yeah, so I don't have to think about it because it's cardio and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, and then just kind of doing some of my PT exercises for me.
Okay. So if you could prioritize, give me your top three areas of pain, discomfort, dysfunction.
Knee, shoulders.
Knee, shoulder?
Knee, and then shoulders.
Okay, so there's only two.
Three. One, two.
Oh, sorry. Both shoulders coming. Okay. Tell me a little bit more about the ribs. Still that weird spongy, because that's what I'm really curious
about.
Yeah,
we can explore that too. I just haven't really done anything with them. Oh, so you know how I get, you might not know. So there's one muscle right above whatever rib that is that'll spasm and pull it out and I can't breathe or anything.
Mm-hmm.
So I had a different one over here. This one was new.
Okay.
On my right, and I would take it, honestly, between the two. This one, I would take this every day. I couldn't turn to my right, but I didn't care because like I could turn my whole body,
right,
which I can't do when the middle one is out. But it was like right on top, which is annoying because that was really hard to get to.
Okay.
Easy
jump.
Okay. So it was like right there was where like the main one was and like pulling from all up in here.
Okay, and how did you get rid of that? How did it just go away?
More or less, like I rolled the shit out of it as much as I could. Had Carrie dig her elbow in there, that was fun.
You know what's gonna help it? I love you.
I mean, really, no, like, yeah, for sure. Finally got to see Yadro towards the end of it and then just stretching it and eating it and doing all the shit I normally do.
Eventually, and trying to not use it.
Yeah, we'll try to not use it with weight, but use it more purposefully to stretch it out, like
mm-hmm.
turning and blah, 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 and like not doing too much heat, et cetera.
Okay. And is it one knee? Is it the left knee?
Yeah.
Okay. Left knee, both shoulders. Are both shoulders equally cruddy?
Yes, in different ways.
Okay. Explain, please. Explain.
So,
I'm specifically interested in your right thumb.
So apparently my right scalenes, they're always out of control, but my right ones in particular are especially out of control right now. Because they were, when I got my massage from Yadra, and she does that amazing thing where she pushes down,
mm-hmm.
The right side was tight where I expected it to be. The left was tight, like, lower. It was
okay.
Weird. It was different than what I had expected. I have more pain in the back left beneath the blade.
Uh-huh.
And then that spot, really, and then it, like, whatever that word is, pinching up or whatever it is.
Okay. So would it be fair to say it's more right front?
It's like in neck? The, it was like in between the clavicle and the whatever that is.
Okay.
Like
so the, right top.
Yeah.
And then left back.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's start you laying real quick. Let's have you laying, can you lay on your belly comfortably?
Yeah.
Okay. So go ahead and do that.
Sure. Yeah.
Okay. So, while lying here, and just kind of take a moment, do you feel that rib sponginess, that retraction that makes you feel weird while you're here? Nope. Okay.
Because my weight is more spread out.
Okay. If you were, for example, to kind of lift your head, chest, and shoulders, will you fold on that rib plane?
Mm.
Good. Anything weird pop up there?
Not yet.
Okay. Go ahead and come back down slowly. And what if you, for example, if I were to ask you to hinge at this point, so do that same thing, but make this point here the fold.
Dig harder so I can feel it.
Oh,
interesting. That's much
tighter
in the diaphragm.
Okay, yes.
And it might actually where that shoulder neck area is.
Okay, so now I have to go ahead and relax. So why that spot in particular, because you automatically, can you feel this?
Mm-hmm.
So this is kind of where you automatically hinge from, and knowing that you have the rib issue, what I'm looking for is basically the line
mm-hmm.
where in the front of your ribs you would get that poke, that bend,
mm-hmm.
that fold in. So looking at that there, you recognize that it was different.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, this time, I want you to slowly enter it again, and I want you to tell me the first sign of that's off might be dangerous, and just explain to me what that is.
Okay. Dig in again. Mm-hmm. If I held it for an extended period of time, right here.
Okay, so that front side of the relax. All right, so that's our number one trigger point here. Go ahead and fold this arm behind. Good, and the only thing I want you to just, again, let me know if there's any discomfort, but I simply want you to lift this elbow and roll this up at the same time, and then come down very gently.
Okay, hold on. Let me pull from the shoulder.
Okay.
What are you doing on my shoulder?
Oh, yes. Okay, nice. So your first movement was scapular retraction and then lifting. You can completely leave your head dead. And I don't necessarily need an isometric. I just want you to do that about 8 times, nice and slow. Same speed up as down.
Okay. I feel it all the way to the base of my skull.
Okay. And as you do it, actually, let's switch to 10.
Okay.
As you do it, I want you to see, is it always there? And if it's always there, can you find a way to do it where that dissipates?
Okay. Lift elbow first.
Okay. And when you lift elbow first, can the shoulder follow then?
Eventually.
Okay. So the distal helps.
I still feel it in the base of my skull, but not nearly as intensely.
Okay. Good. And try to smooth, get it a little bit smoother on the way down. Again, everything should be the same pace reversed. Same pace reversed, same actions reversed. So if it goes elbow, shoulder, then shoulder should come down, then elbow should come down. Good. Ooh, something's changing. I'll tell you in a second, in a good way, I think. Is it affecting your base of your skull less or more?
Mm.
As you're doing it, like this 7
As I keep going, it feels more constant.
Oh. So the pain is getting worse?
Not a pain, but like a stretch, like a tension.
Okay.
Instead of just straight at the base of the skull, it's more of the whole line.
Okay, so spreading laterally?
Yes.
Okay, so more people, more things are helping that one line. Perfect. Then let's keep continuing. Good, and really try to make sure when that elbow hits and you're at rest, everything is off. Don't reset until we have fully dead.
I notice I'm unconsciously clenching over here.
Okay. Trying to hold into the ground.
Mm-hmm.
Again, not just not a terrible thing, but a good spot, a good catch. That time, just your scapula initiated, which was cool because it's starting. I don't know if you probably can't feel it go hard, but it's starting to automatically do this all by itself, just with a few reps.
Good.
Nice. That time it was like, I'm coming, come with me.
It definitely does, it feels more synchronized.
Cool. And I think with your awareness, like that's kind of the jam. I usually don't do too many reps with people, but for you, each rep is like the tendrils are going out and what could happen. So I would recommend what you're doing as you do stuff higher reps so you can get the right feel.
That's usually what I prefer anyway.
Okay.
And I don't necessarily feel the synchronization in the back with the scapular, but I definitely feel it more in the front of the shoulder.
Okay. So we'll do a few more and then I'll start making some adjustments to your head and neck and see how that affects it. Because right now everything is face down. The only thing that's kind of working is the shoulder arm. Oh yeah, that's moving much better.
Feels better.
Check that. Yeah. And so we're gonna do the same motion, but I'm gonna have you decide. You're just simply gonna adjust your head in looking a certain way. You already knew what to do. So let's try a few more this way and see.
I was doing it mostly to hear you, but okay.
Oh, to hear me better?
Yeah.
Okay, is this how you would like to?
Sure, I mean, that's the, it wasn't a bad kind of tension, but it was starting to get
fatigued.
Well, not fatigued, like sore because we're working at a muscle that's not used to being worked out, and it's a small muscle, it's not a big major muscle group.
Yeah.
So this helps.
Especially
really
if there's compensators. It's like, no, I'm not at the front of the line.
Yeah, like, I'm back here for a reason. So this helps stretch that out really good.
Awesome.
Well, that's an interesting stretch. That's like a pectoral stretch. That's
Which is, especially through that front side top.
Yeah, but the body weight.
And so the neck, if you have to think, the neck is turned away. So those front things, right, have a little bit of extension and stretch. This left side of your head is actually turned towards the, right? So it's actually closer than it typically is. So just seeing what play rotation has. Does this affect that kind of occipital spot?
Not even feeling it at all.
Okay.
It's not even a thing.
Okay.
Is my elbow still going? I don't know that it was necessarily always going up and down, but is it going the same trajectory as it was when my head was face down?
Yes.
Okay, good.
Yes.
It doesn't feel like it, but
It as I look at it, and I'd have to check the tape, it might be going a little higher versus straight up, but that's not a negative thing. Because again, we twisted the top.
Yeah, so but I just don't want to like put it up.
Oh, correct. Yes. No, I see what you're saying.
Oh, that's much harder.
Harder?
Yeah.
Okay.
It feels more awkward.
Right, so the interesting thing is this shoulder flew up.
Interesting.
Like, so the shoulder movement, which is scapular movement, that chest opened up a ton more.
Weird, but like the rest of my body is trying to compensate for it. Like I keep tensing in my left side. That's super weird. What?
And if you feel it would be helpful, you could like, for example, bend this knee, bring the foot in the air, adjust this, and just to see, right? If you can get that,
That helps me actually not tense.
Right, it's like we're gonna distract you with holding this foot in the air.
Yeah. That's weird. That's very awkward and janky. Like my body doesn't like that. Like it's fine. It's mm-hmm. just like I'm very uncomfortable. This is a nice stretch. This is much more comfortable.
Okay. So you don't like rotating in, creates a pinch point. What you with the direction, and again, we're finding better and worse.
Yeah.
And it feels also always better to go to the better. But the
shift
barrier is always in that worse. So it's like, how do we...
Well, and it's not like a physical discomfort, but just like...
a mental.
That's weird.
Oh, does it feel almost like a threat? Like,
not a threat, just like, we don't do this. Like, it's totally like a newborn baby.
Okay.
Like, trying to figure out how to walk. Like, it's very...
Okay. Funny. Yeah. And that baby needs... Right? You know, it's like years the baby's like, how do I hold this head up?
Yeah. This is weird. Oh, my elbow feels totally uncoordinated.
Yeah, there's a little hitch in it, which is very interesting, because again, it's motor control.
My shoulder does feel bad, like I can feel it, but it feels like it's up all the time now. It doesn't feel like it's going up and down as much.
Yeah, feel free to slide your hand, you know, towards the door, towards the garage door.
Like that?
Either way. Okay. You can also rotate it up or down. So that's the distal, and you could also manipulate the head a bit to coordinate an up-down with the elbow to see if that extra chin down or chin up, even though it's in that position, to see which variation.
Well, that's super weird. I don't like that.
Okay. Okay, chin down.
That was weird.
Or scary.
That was bizarre. Like that, my scapulars were like, what are you doing?
Too many variables.
Well, it's like we don't have any room to move. Hello.
Yeah.
Well, that's a little bit better. Still feels awkward, but it's a little bit better.
And if you looked up, more pleasant, less pleasant, more space?
Still feels like awkward and uncoordinated.
Okay. But less so than the chin down.
Yeah. Mostly the chin down was like my scapulars were like, hey, we can't flex. We don't have enough room to flex.
And then if I...
Is my wrist supposed to be the hinge point or my fingertips?
Whatever you choose.
Okay.
Yep, it could be either.
Yeah, I'll do the first.
It just would lengthen the lever a little bit.
Yeah. I don't like long levers. So,
it is more effort, typically. So if I add, then again, keep rocking. If I add this next piece of...
You want me to do a proper rotation?
I want to see how. And again, feet could be doing anything, head could be anywhere.
That's so much effort. Oh my gosh. Okay, here we go. Hold on. That's so much thinking.
So you basically, you just want to, you're going to go from there, and you just basically want that thumb top of the head.
Hold on.
Again, does it need to look any certain way?
I got to make sure my shoulder's not bunching up to try and get my elbow to go.
Okay.
Oh, that's difficult. Nope, I'm losing it.
It's okay. Yeah, if you need to slide, it's okay to slide.
Well, it's more of feedback. Like, I am unable to keep it up.
And I guess that's what I mean. Like, it is okay to slide it if you can't keep it
up. Yeah, I don't feel that. I'm just, like, giving you feedback.
Oh, I see. Yes. And part of that is, again, that arm's going to lift, like you're talking about leverage, if the scapula can pull it in. Right, so there's a weak point there.
Mm-hmm, which we knew. I can't do overhead stuff. Let's do this.
You can also adjust your hips in any position that you want.
Oh!
Uh-huh, look at that! Crazy awkward, I hate this. It's like, actually, I'm going to show you how to do it.
Yeah, like, I got this.
Ooh.
That's crazy.
Nice. Now, as you do this a few more times, try to see if you could feel that sequence and that tension line, and then see if you could repeat it with head facing down before we get to head to the other side. This memorization of how is this doing this and with such ease.
I'm gonna make sure that you can see my shoulder, make sure it's not bunching up.
Okay.
Because I don't
That doesn't need to do anything else.
That's done.
Yeah, what's neat is that your shoulder, your body knows is very spatially acutely aware of mm-hmm. where things are in space. That shoulder does not move any extra. It knows exactly where your head is.
Good.
That was a little bit more. You're like, okay, I got more.
Good. I'm trying to listen to the rest of my eye. Mm-hmm.
And that other rotating piece that is layered on top of this is really cool, is that you've been laying on your ribs. Right? The spongy
usually it's when I get up.
Okay. And you took it. I noticed when you took your jacket off if there was anything there, and it seemed pretty smooth. And part of it might be this glute stuff going on. Which, do it. That's fine. Good. Can you feel the same sequence? And you can always go back and forth to compare.
If you have the same sequence, there's a different tension right here.
Okay. Different, can you explain any more?
Like, it's tensing more.
Okay.
Like, the muscle... So
it needs to do more?
Like, it's trying to do more, but because we already had it do things that's not used to, so it's already tired, and so now it might...
Got it.
It's
neck
like,
was,
I'm going to cramp.
Got it. Neck was helping in that old position, and now the neck is less torque to help. Whenever you're ready to try that other side. Yeah. Also think about that rib cage middle. Is there anything there that changed when you turned your head? Does anything flatten that used to be holding you kind of when you lifted yourself off the mat? Sometimes when there's a head position, right? Mm-hmm. So if I were to do it this way, this is the ground, and I turn my head, there can be a, like, this tends to flatten and pull
mm-hmm.
when I turn that head. So I'm just curious if you feel that. And when I go to this way,
mm-hmm.
right, it will automatically lift.
I was feeling the wrong ribs. Hold on. No.
Okay. Good. Let's just do one more because I know that thing's getting fatigued.
That center not better when I thought.
Yeah.
That.
Yeah. So in general, again, no extra things, just building off successes and able to get what we did get when we couldn't a second ago. Now, I'm curious, just give a few to this side. I know it has a little different trajectory and issue problem spot, but curious how.
As long as rotation doesn't matter, it's fine.
Yeah. Well, that guy is like, I am off the ground. Big time. Like, that guy's like, I actually hate the ground.
I mean, well, this side is my mobile side, so.
But I thought there was the issue.
Elbow
that side. Sorry, I thought you said the.
Yeah, so that muscle, when it does spasm, it's always the same one and it's always in the same spot.
Okay.
But it's not always spasming.
Got it. Okay. If you, since this is the precarious side, when you feel the first inkling of that might go, let me know.
Oh, I will.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know. We can see this video when it's up, but it's night and day, the amount of elbow lift and shoulder lift.
Oh, sure. It feels better. It feels much less awkward, and it's like it's ready to go.
And which is the side that you broke your forearm? Okay.
So, like, if you have you put something, I can't. So this wrist can't. This hand can't grab it totally.
Okay.
If it's flat.
Got it. Okay. So I wonder if the again adaptation, because your forearm is able to rotate less, your shoulder scapula has been forced to do more of that action.
That's possible, because if I go from the outside in and my forearm and hand have been doing stuff on my right side because it can,
mm-hmm.
it never had to learn how to actually do things.
Mm.
That would make sense.
Mm-hmm. And this one was like, actually, it's all scapula shoulder length.
Yeah. Which, honestly, I'll take. It hurts less.
Mm.
I'm sure probably the reason it hurts so much is because the right pulls on it and it doesn't get equal whatever.
Yeah, there's certainly compensations.
So I was telling the doctor today, I have 100% rotation, or whatever, I have 100% mobility, it's just not necessarily 50-50.
Right.
Oh, that feels nice.
Good.
I like this one.
It's always nice when it's pleasant.
Yeah.
Now, my bigger curiosity on this side is when, again, I don't want to stop your pleasure, go as much as you'd like here and explore here, but I am curious to see how the overhead adjusts.
That'll be interesting.
Particularly because I think this scapula is great at retraction, protraction, but might not be great at...
Well, and it doesn't necessarily have the strength.
Hmm.
So that'll be interesting to see. That's what I'm curious about. Oh, my whole body was in.
Helping. And again, we have to remember that the body's natural inclination when a limb is lifted is for others to help push down.
Mm-hmm. That feels so much better than I thought it would.
Good.
Like, it's working so much better than I thought it would.
Hmm. The other thing, too, just because of your, like, mental access, I wonder if it learned from all those reps on the other side. Like, you're like, oh, I know the sequence.
It might have. They don't usually talk to each other, though.
Hmm. But that brain, that awareness of the brain, do you know what I mean? Like,
yeah, that's weird. Yeah, it feels much... So it's a different tension. It's actually... So it's tensing kind of in that spot, not in an unpleasant way or a threatening way, but that's the muscle, probably because that's the muscle that does everything on that side, so that's why it's mad so often, but that I feel that tension of that muscle more so when I'm moving this one.
Okay.
Like I said, not necessarily in a threatening way, but that's interesting.
It's letting you know.
Yeah, that's weird. It's letting me know that it's, like, doing all the work.
Mm-hmm.
Interesting.
And as I see that, I'm going to replicate something real quick. Okay.
Interesting.
Let me know when your fatigue. I don't want to over fatigue because I want to try to build one more layer. Are you
good?
Let's
do another layer.
Okay. So, stand and roll.
Okay.
So, if I look like you, is that the easiest way to do it? Where are you?
Face me.
Okay. So, over here.
Mm.
Here.
Do baby. Hate the baby roll.
And then, so the key though is like, can we utilize this opening? And let the body, again, you are going to feel free to use your legs in any way.
I'm going to have to, I hate the baby roll.
Let your body.
Ugh, okay, fine.
I'm so sorry, it's so disgusting to
you. I hate the baby roll. I can do the legs now. I hate the arm baby roll so much. Okay, here we go.
And again, and think, so, and actually, let me pause you. Think of it less as any particular type of roll, and only think of it as, hey, I want to use this initial elbow shoulder lift to get me to the other side.
Okay.
Think about when that arm might go overhead. So if I recreate it here against the wall. So could I not like get my elbow caught?
Mm-hmm.
Can I figure out that nice,
mm-hmm.
I'm gonna be reaching as I'm turning.
Yeah.
Yes, head followed. Very nice. The other arm, you're doing an excellent job. I can tell you've done lots of rolls because it's like, go dead. But you can, right? You can stiffen through the rib so that this doesn't have to get stuck, that it can kind of go over it.
Okay.
Ooh, that was a little.
That was not my arm at all.
And that's okay.
Show me again.
Okay. Actually, go back to your first side. And let's see if you can teach yourself. This side was much more fluid.
Okay.
Elbow, shoulder, head, hand. Yep. And you can repeat it again. Elbow, shoulder, head, hand. This is just my visual catch of what's happening.
Yeah, no.
It's the
I'm not feeling anything. That's so weird. That's all leg pushing me over. I'm not feeling anything under here. Weird. I know what I'm supposed to be feeling. I just don't know how to activate those muscles.
Well, let's take it from a side. So see this position you got right here? Scoot it this way a little bit. And flip it. We're going to start there. So flip to this side.
See what?
So you're behind your side?
Oh, I see.
Yep.
I see.
And you're gonna have that hand back behind.
Got it.
Yep. So again, elbow, hand, when do I lift?
It feels closer.
Uh-huh.
And still not quite.
And give it a few reps to think about the same reverse of closing.
Yeah.
You could also think of closing, opening up through the hips.
Okay, that'd be good. Okay.
Use opening and closing as those instructions. Think about how the reach is happening. I think that's the other.
I think you're right.
It tends to go out instead of that natural, like, elbow travels up, 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 up.
Will you stab whatever muscle is supposed to be putting it up?
Sure, sure.
Feel it?
Yeah.
Which one is it?
So we're going to go from the backside, yeah.
Okay.
So, show me.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay. Go for it. Versus, your inclination is here. Stay down, stay down, stay down.
Okay. Like stab, will you stab it?
Okay.
Like, yeah, dig deep so I can get the mental. There it is.
Yes.
There.
So the key is to make the elbow travel on an upward.